वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ न्यू टॉपिक। बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लेसन आई वॉन्ट टू आस्क यू फ्यू क्वेश्चंस, एंड इफ यू नो द आंसर रेज योर हैंड। टेल मी स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ डू यू गेट इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट एनी टॉपिक? येस, वी कैन गेट नॉलेज, वी कैन गेट द इन्फॉर्मेशन बाय द हेल्प ऑफ इंटरनेट, बुक्स, आर्टिकल एंड सो ऑन। बट स्टूडेंट्स, डू यू नो हाउ पीपल यूज टू गेट इन्फॉर्मेशन इन द पास्ट? Today we are going to learn about that. Our today's topic name is lesson number 4, the Vedic civilization. So students, what is Vedic civilization? The Vedic civilization or the Vedic age is the period in the late Bronze Age and early Iron Age in the history of India. The Vedic civilization that is based on Vedic literature is known as Vedic civilization. Now we will see the most important part of Vedic civilization, and it is the Vedic literature. So let's learn the information about Vedic literature. The Vedas are considered to be our earliest literature. The Vedas were composed by many sages or rishis. Some Vedic hymns were composed by women also. Vedic literature is in Sanskrit language. Vedic literature is very rich and diverse. The Vedic texts are known as Samhita. Vid means to know. The term Veda derives from the word Vid. It means knowledge. There are four Vedas: Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda and Atharva Veda. So let's learn this Veda one by one. First one is the Rig Veda. Rigveda is an ancient Indian religious book. It is also one of the oldest writings in Sanskrit language. Each verse of the Veda is known as Richa. So the Veda consisting of Richas is called Rigveda. Richa means a verse composed to praise a deity. When a number of Richas are put together to praise a particular deity, the poetic composition is called Sukta. The Rigveda consists of many suktas composed to praise different deities. The second one is Yajurveda. The Yajurveda contains mantras uttered during a yajna. Yajurveda provides guidance about how and when the different mantras must be chanted during yajna rites. This text includes the verse or poetic incantations and their explanation in prose. The next one is Samveda. The Samveda provide guidance on singing Rigvedic verse to set rhyme and tunes at the time of yajna rites. The Samveda has contributing in the major way in laying the foundation of Indian music. The next last one is Atharva Veda. The Atharva Veda is named after Atharva Rishi. This Veda is different from the other three Vedas. It is more concerned with many things in the day-to-day life of the people. It includes solutions to adversities and diseases. It also provides information about medicinal herbs. The Atharva Veda provides guidance to a king about the way he should administer his kingdom. Students, along with this, there are some more important literature in that Vedic civilization, which is Brahmana, Aranyaka and Upanishada. The Brahmana texts, Aranyakas and Upanishadas were written after the composition of the Samhitas. They are also included in our Vedic literature. So let's learn these texts one by one. First one is Brahmana text. They were composed to provide guidance on using Vedic mantras in yajna rituals. Each Veda has independent texts called Brahmanas. The next one is Aranyakas. Aranyakas consist of the reflection or thoughts expressed after meditating with deep concentration in forest. The Aranyakas are concerned with accurate performance of yajna rites. And the last one is Upanishada. The term Upanishad indicates knowledge acquired by sitting on the at the feet of the teacher. Human beings have always wondered about events like life and death. It is not easy to find answer to them. The Upanishads discuss such serious and profound issues. The four Vedas, Brahmanas, Aranyakas and Upanishads were composed over a period of 1500 years. During this long period, the Vedic civilization underwent many changes. The Vedic literature is an important source of the study of those changes and of the day-to-day life in the Vedic period. So students, let's rewind the topic. So what we have learned today? Today we will learn the important part of Vedic civilization, that is Vedic literature. It was earliest literature of Hinduism. There are four main Vedic literature: Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda and Atharva Veda. And along with this, Brahmana, Aranyaka and Upanishadha, this text also plays an important role in the Vedic civilization. This literature provide information about political, social, economic, religious and cultural life of the people of the Vedic period. So students, there is small evaluation. You have to answer these questions. Question number one, answer in one word. First question is, the language of Vedic literature is? Yes, very good. It is in Sanskrit language. Second one is, the meaning of Vit word. Yes, Vit means to know. Question number two, fill in the blanks. First, the civilization which is based on Vedic literature is known as? Yes, very good. Vedic civilization. The Vedic literature is in dash language? Yes, Vedic literature is in Sanskrit language. Each verse of the Veda is known as dash? Yes, very good. Each verse of the Veda is known as Richa. So students, you have a small assignment. You have to write down short notes on Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda and Atharva Veda. Students, I hope you understand today's topic. Thank you.